G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I've got to say that when I looked at this thing, for some reason I just thought it looked like more like a bat sub or bat boat. Some of the Batman kits that come out, some of them are good, some of them aren't too good, especially the bat boat, one of the Revell's modern bat boat. I just think it looks absolutely tragic, or, you know, the design of it. So when I saw this, I thought, God, this is such a cooler vehicle for Batman. Especially if you whacked a couple of bat wings on each side of it. But anyway, a couple of things I really like about this kit to start off with is it's 1/20th in scale. A lot of the Mac kits obviously are, so when I saw this pilot straight away, I thought, well, this pilot doesn't look half decent, I might throw a Mac pilot in there instead. I don't know if I've mentioned this too much in some of my other videos, but I absolutely love, two things. When you actually get a decent size canopy, and also when you also get a pilot inside. So, you know, years ago, probably didn't happen too much. But now with all the fiber optics and the little LEDs you can get and everything like that, you could really go to town lighting this kit up. To show you the sides of the box, as you know, I'm a sucker for figures. So as soon as I saw the side of the box and I saw the figure sitting in there, I just thought, I've just got to pick this up. You get this funny little base with it, which is quite interesting, but it's better than nothing. And I think this was over here. We've got 1994. This is quite a large kit, I think. This one here looks pretty awkward. I don't think I'd be picking that one up. And this one here is pretty cool as well. I quite like this one as well, the little deep ocean transport. Unfortunately, some of these older models, when you actually look at them like this on their box art compared to what you actually get in the kit, is a bit of a different story. And I suppose that's what I like about this one. This one pretty much looks pretty much like it is. And obviously, this is from the Sequest show. And I'm going to be honest with you guys. I think I might have watched the show maybe once or twice. But I can't remember anything about it. But I can remember as far back as, you know, Battlestar Galactica. You know, the original series. And can remember all of that. So, and Buck Rogers. And what else is there? Blake Seven. But I can't remember much about this. So, obviously, it didn't either grab my attention or I was just, you know, probably out and about when this show was on. Anyway, I think it only went for like 2.5 seasons and then it sort of got cancelled anyway. You gotta love opening up these old kits. Here you have the base here and it's all in black, which is, you don't often see too many kits in black. I did get my MiG Stealth Fighter in black as well that I've just recently done, but don't recall. And I think a couple of the Mac kits I've just picked up recently. Might have been one of the Croak kits, might have been in black as well, or dark grey. Always fear about when you get these kits, when you get something like this, that you're going to have a big, ugly scratch on top of your canopy here. It's interesting, actually. There's quite a bit of dust on this, so it looks like it might be the cardboard. Sort of just flaked off a bit. But it's good news, guys, is there's no scratches on this, and this is a huge canopy. I mean, if we're looking at it here, it's roughly around 13 centimeters long, or 130 mil. That's what Mr. Kangaroo says. You're definitely going to get a good viewing inside if you want to do a lot of fiber optics and everything like that. Let's grab the instructions, eh? And what do we got here? I do love these little random things you find in old kits. This is quite strange because they've got all these aircraft, but they actually don't have any, I'm guessing it's monogram on the front of it, which is pretty interesting. You think they'd actually put monogram on the front. And we'll have a look on the back. They've got it on the back here. Look at these old things. Just such a piece of history. I mean, now with the internet, you know, I mean, look at this sort of stuff. Would you be interested in a model builders club? Yes or no? I mean, guys, I mean, if you're not a young lad, this is just crazy. Brings back a lot of memories. Young people are very lucky today. I mean, imagine sending yes and you tick that off and you put your address and everything like that. You send it off and you probably maybe never hear anything back. I don't know. But I mean, God, now you just get on the internet, YouTube and go bang. And you basically look at anything you want when it comes to modeling, especially when you're watching my channel. So much good stuff. Here's some decals here. Fortunately, they were stuck to the plastic. I've had that happen a couple of times. I've got a Battlestar Galactica kit that I'll show where the decals have sort of stuck to the plastic wrapping stuff, and it sort of has affected the decals a bit. But I won't be using these decals anyway, but I might use this as a template to cut out for some Tamiya masking tape or something like that. And they've got a couple of little decals up the top there. They don't do too many instructions like this anymore with the artwork like this. except for when you're lucky and you get a couple of little Ralph Macquarie little cards or something in the Battlestar Galactica kits. A little bit of info down there for you guys to read if you're interested. Oh, guys, this is my kind of kit. Two parts, it's part one. Oh, look at this, part two. God, you gotta love these type of old kits, don't you? But I mean, look at all the buttons and the dials and what have you in this thing. I mean, holy dooly, you could go plasmo on this, seriously. Look at the amount of lighting you could whack into this thing. There's almost more parts on the pilot than there is on the actual model kit. I've got to give a shout out to Monogram because I'm actually really happy that they've put an actual figure in this model. So many kits don't put figures in their models, and it does bug me a little bit. So I absolutely love it when a model company actually puts a figure in their kit. Absolutely love it. Jeez, guys, this is an absolute weekend build. If you're after a nice quick weekend build and you're still in lockdown, you can find one of these little fellas. They're still around on eBay. You can find them from time to time. Some of the prices on eBay, whew, are absolutely ridiculous. And, you know, to some degree, I can sort of see, you got two sides of the story. You know, sometimes you look at a kit and go, oh, that is so expensive. Why would anyone pay that for it? But you know what? If they're sort of hard to find and one only turns up on eBay once in a blue moon or, you know, once every year, and that's even if you actually get to buy it, someone else doesn't outbid you first or anything like that, they can be really hard to get. Some kits, I'm not saying this one, but some kits. So it's one of those annoying things to some degree when you're actually looking for models, because you know you're not paying for the quality of the kit, to so to speak, because you can go out and buy a brand new Tamiya kit or a Bandai kit that will, you know, knock these kits out of the park. But the problem is that Bandai and Tamiya don't make this type of kit. You don't have a choice. You're paying probably top dollar for an old kit, but if it's the only one in town, you know, it's whether how much you like it, I suppose, or how long you're prepared to wait before you can find one somewhere else. I'm sure there's heaps of modelers out here that have this kit in their stash and it's just sitting there, like this one in the canal downstairs in my place. But, you know, some people are happy to let them to go. And like myself, I don't want to let this go. I absolutely love this kit. I do like the base because I actually do think you could really weather this base up, and with all the pastels and pigment stuff you can get these days, and even the resin water, you could really go to town on this thing. Even this picture here, I just think it looks so cool. Absolutely love it. Well, I do think that you could easily put a Batman in there though, and paint it all black, and you know, put a couple of Batman symbols on it, and I reckon you could get away with it. But you know, I'm crazy like that, guys. I'm crazy. Let's open this baby up. I really wish Bandai would, you know, or even Tamiya. I'd love if Tamiya picked up some of these older kits or the licenses. I really don't understand, and probably I'm not I like Bandai, but I'm not a big fan of their plastic. I've talked about before in some of my other videos how you can't use certain types of thinners on their plastic because it's going to crack. So I'm really not a big fan, given how big Bandai is, that they haven't sort of rectified that issue to some degree. But I'd love, you know, for someone like Tamiya or Meng, or who else is there out there? I don't know. Look, I'd say Dragon, but Dragon kind of annoys me a bit. They're a bit of hit and miss with their kits. I mean, even, what is it? Hasegawa. Their Mac kits are fantastic, even if they picked up some of these sci-fi lines. I really don't understand it. And at the moment with Mobius models, and I know that someone else or something, but what the hell's going on with Mobius at the moment? I mean, it's very hard to pick up a 132 scale Cylon Raider at the moment, or their Vipers, they go in and out, you know, whether it was Mobius or I think Revell took them over. But it's disgraceful, guys, how you can go into a hobby shop and you can't even find a Revell or Mobius Viper, Battlestar Galactica Viper. I mean, I don't know what's going on in this world today. I mean, you know, Bandai 172, 144th, no Battlestar Galactica Vipers or Cylon Raiders from Mobius. I mean, that was a classic kit. What the hell's going on with this world? Anyway, I digress. Most people probably turned off by now. But anyway, these are raised panel lines, which I don't mind because you can still run a wash down either side of them. And you sort of bring out the detail a bit. And, you know, I wouldn't say that this is, you know, flowing with detail, guys. It's not, you know, it's from the 90s, so it's not that old, you know. Sometimes you say old, but, you know, it is old, but it's not old, if you know what I mean. And the only thing I was really worried about, which I've seen a couple of little things on YouTube, that I think the canopy fits all right, not like the, what was it, the Mobis Raptor? I think there was a bit of a boo-boo there in the moulding process of the cockpit for the Raptor, so just be mindful of that if you're building that. You might need a little bit of extra putty or to a little rim around the bottom of the cockpit to hide the sort of gaps. But guys, I mean, look at this. In fact, when I look at this figure, it really does sort of remind me of an old Mac figure, maybe from the Croat or something like that. As soon as I saw it, I thought, geez, that does remind me of one of those older Mac kits out of the earlier days. But this is pretty much the money shot, guys. Not that it might be whatever studio or screen accurate, but look at the amount of detail, all these buttons, flip things, whatever it is. But I mean, if you wanted to make your own up, you could have this thing flashing like Samantha Fox. Oh look, my figure's just about falling off anyway, so given that he's threatening to fall off, we might as well take him off. Come on, little fella. Oh god, settle down. So while we've got him off, we might as well sit him in here. Oh guys, look at that. You gotta love that. They really sculpted and molded this little figure to sit in there quite nicely. So I don't know, it'd be hard to change his figure now. I was thinking about changing him over, but he's got such a nice posture in this kit. I don't think I could change the actual figure. I could always sculpt a little bit of a different uniform on him a little bit, but the actual posture with him sitting in there, it looks absolutely fantastic. What I probably would do is I'd probably change the head. It's not that bad for, you know, it's age, and you could definitely paint it up to look half decent. But I think I'd just like to put probably a bit of a different head on him, possibly. I'll have a look around and see what I can find that'll fit sort of reasonably well on his little collar there without having to do too much work. Now, unless it's run off on me somewhere, which I find it hard given that I've just opened up on the table here, but I think I may be missing, and I could be wrong, one arm to the figure, which is kind of interesting. I did pick this up on eBay a long time ago, but it was sealed, so that's quite interesting. So I've got one arm here. I'll have to go back and check my my footage when I've opened this up, because I've got one arm there. I'm guessing the other arm was over here. But it's nowhere to be seen, guys. Let me know if you see it crawl off somewhere. Very strange. I think my kit only came with one arm. Well, I might have to get in, after all, to some of my old Mac kits and possibly find another arm for this little fella. Or change both arms, I'm guessing. If I can't find this silly arm somewhere. Damn you, arm. Where are you? Anyway, guys. Just another wonderful sci-fi kit to add to my sci-fi playlist. Hope you enjoyed looking at this one. I think it's a pretty cool little kit. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you later.